breaking news is happening now.
That breaking news, Michael Astorga guilty of first-degree murder. The jury came back with a verdict just hours ago. We have reporters covering every angle of this story for you tonight. Let's begin, though, with Rod Green. He is live downtown and was in the courtroom when that verdict was read.
Very emotional courtroom, too. You know, it took the jurors about 15 hours or so, give or take a few 15-minute breaks, to come up with that verdict over the past 3 days or so. And when it was read in the courtroom, the McGrane family broke openly into tears of relief after 4 years of basically kind of living a nightmare in limbo, finding out what's going to happen to their son's alleged killer, now convicted killer. Defense attorney Gary Mitchell, visibly upset about the whole thing. Of course, he now has to fight the death penalty in a few months and trying to keep his prisoner out of death row. As far as the jury was concerned, Carrie Brandenburg talked to a couple of those jurors, and she told us that those last-minute alibi witnesses that came forward 4 years after the murder actually hurt the defense case, but Mitchell was unapologetic.
In this day and age, the American public thinks if you don't go to the authorities, you must be guilty of something. And for those of us that don't trust the authorities or know how they act and know how irresponsible they can be at times, I think that the failure to go to them sometimes is the only way that you can survive and the only way you can protect witnesses that you need to call later on. So it's a tremendous...
Now Mitchell is going to have to crank up his defense for that death penalty phase of the trial. That should begin sometime in September. Now let's go to Christy Oletto, who has more information on how the McGranes reacted to today's verdict. Christy?
Yeah. And Rod, the McGrane family came here to the DA's office shortly after the verdict was read. Obviously, they were elated by the decision, but the McGrane family says that this is just the first step in getting justice served for their son.
We've been very nervous, and we haven't slept very much at night.
Whirlwind of emotions for the McGrane family, starting with the loss of their son, Deputy James McGrane, in March of 2006. And for the past 4 weeks, the exhausting, detailed, and emotional trial filled with graphic testimony. And today, finally, a guilty verdict for the man who killed their son. The McGranes say it was hard not knowing what verdict the jury would return.
You're never sure what the jury's going to do. And we knew if we had a relatively quick decision, it'd probably go in our favor. We knew if we went into next week and maybe to the end of next week, maybe we'd have a hung jury.
Now, James McGrane Sr. says now they're getting ready for the next phase, which is preparing for the sentencing of convicted cop killer Michael Astorga. But just to give you guys an idea of how this has really impacted the community, we went on to James McGrane's Facebook page, and we really saw an outpour of posts from the public, a lot of celebratory comments on there. So it's really impacted the community. Reporting live downtown, Christy Oletto, KOAT Action 7 News.
And Action 7 News reporter Will Carr caught up with Michael Astorga's family after the verdict, and he joins us now live outside of the courthouse.
Astorga's mom walked outside. She was really unemotional, and she tells us that she simply was not surprised. Now, the one thing she did talk to us about, she tells us that she was not pleased with the district attorney's closing arguments. Now, people in the courtroom say that Carrie Brandenburg got choked up during her final plea to the jury, but Michael Astorga's mom tells us she simply didn't buy it.
Oh, my God, somebody must have put onions under her eyes. Because she has about as much compassion as, I don't see any compassion from the woman.
And she tells us that she did not get to speak to her son right after the verdict and right when before he was taken into custody. She tells us that she hopes that she can talk to him some point tonight, but and will tell you exactly what she plans to tell him coming up tonight on Action 7 News at 10. Right now, reporting live downtown, Will Carr, KOAT, Action 7 News.
And let's get you caught up on some history in this case. Today's guilty verdict has been 4 emotional years in the making, beginning with a routine traffic stop on that fateful night. Deputy James McGrain Jr. is gunned down during a traffic stop in the East Mountains on March 22nd in 2006. Not long after, police identify Michael Astorga as the murder suspect. A week later, police get a tip on Astorga's whereabouts and start searching for him in the area of an Albuquerque high school. In April of 2006, Astorga is captured in Mexico. Police say he had been hiding out in Juarez. FBI agents in El Paso extradite Astorga back to Albuquerque. About a week after that, a Bernalillo County grand jury indicted Michael Astorga for murder and three other felonies in McGrain's death. In June of 2006, District Attorney Carrie Brandenburg announces she will handle the case and will seek the death penalty. After years of motions and legal maneuvering, jury selection finally began a month ago. And today, a jury found Astorga guilty of McGrain's murder. And up next is the death penalty phase of this trial. A new jury will be selected to hear evidence to decide if Astorga should be put to death. And stay with Action 7 News for continuing coverage of the Michael Astorga guilty verdict. And go to our website, KOAT.com, to review all of our past coverage dating back to 2006. You can find it in the orange box on our homepage.